The Pocketbook Touch Lux 4 Premium Limited Edition comes with a free case. We're just going to explore that first because that's basically the reason you'll buy this. Here it is. It looks like an aluminum brushed appearance to it on the outside. It is not. It is flexible. It is featuring very soft kind of rubber on the outside. And on the inside, it's felt. And that's to not damage the screen, even though it is a sunken screen. You have a little insert here. Just take that out. Take the silica gel out. And you have some flexible rubber as well. It's not as flexible as, just say, a silicone phone case. And that design from the front rolls over onto the side. Pocketbook has a metallic feel logo on the front and an embossed logo on the inside cover as well. Let's explore the rest of the device. You have a very nice home screen. You have some recent books. It does move left and right, and it is not necessarily a carousel. It actually refreshes all three every single time, so it won't go step by step. You have today's new books down below, library, store, browser, and if you click on the top, it drops down the top. You have task manager, sync, settings, search, and a bunch of notifications you can see right there. I haven't attended to any of them. And if you click the bottom, you actually get some apps like Dropbox, Dictionary, Pocketbook Cloud, RSS News, Klondike Chess, Calculator, etc. These are not apps in the Android sense because this is not running Android, it is Linux, but they are applications all the same. Looking at an EPUB book, we have lots of ways to change the page. We have swipe, we have tap, and we have the physical page turn buttons down below. Now, this being a reading-centric device, we are going to focus primarily on reading because it isn't running Android. You can't download Facebook or anything like that. So all that's just kind of unnecessary. What does the long press experience bring? Well, you have highlight. You can highlight that. You also get some anchors when you long press as well. So that's very nice. You have scribble, which we're going to show you in a sec. We have take notes. And we can take notes and say, Peter. It isn't a conventional QWERTY keyboard because everything's stacked. And the text does take a little bit of time to generate. It doesn't miss anything, but it does take a little bit of time. And you can see highlights are the highlights. And highlights with a little triangle at the corner means note. So long pressing, we can explore the rest. We have search on Google, dictionary, and we have a share button as well here. And it does take a second, and it does have to realize what it's doing, but it'll actually send the passage. And once it does load, it sends it to read rate. And what that is actually a service kind of like if Amazon had Goodreads, Pocketbook would have read rate. It's their own proprietary kind of service. You can sign in with Facebook, Twitter, and a bunch of the other ones I really don't know, VK, Odlanaleski, and then you have Bookland, and of course Google Plus or LinkedIn. You do have some ways to change the text as well. So you go to the bottom and you have a slider bar that allows you to change the text via a lot of different points. It's not just seven levels like an Amazon device. This one actually has very little limits. You can just go point by point by point. You have margins as well and line spacing, so you can make everything really tight and have a lot of text showing on the screen. You also have hyphenations on or off. If you click the little font thing, you have regular, italic, bold. Not everyone will allow you to do that. And you can change the font style as well. And you can slide the slider bar at the left here. It does have a little bit of inertia, which means after you slide, it'll keep kind of rolling and slow down and until it kind of stops. It's not the most comfortable of experience, but the scrolling does actually function pretty well. You also have rotate, note, and dictionary. And dictionary is the same whether you click on it or you define a word by clicking on the word. Now, one of the most most interesting things about this device is if you long press on something, you actually get this right here, and this is scribble. Very, very few devices actually allow you to take notes on an EPUB, and I don't mean take notes with your keyboard. It's actually take notes via the scribble feature, and that is amazing because devices don't usually allow you to do that. And we're going to stop there because we're going to save this for the note-taking portion of this video, and we're going to use a Goody Reader capacitive stylus to show off what this thing can actually do. We all get a huge kick out of this because it's weird how a device that has nothing to do with note-taking whatsoever exists amongst all these note-taking devices, Supernote, Boyu, Onyx, and everyone else, and they have the ability to actually take capacitive notes. It isn't the quickest, it's not the most comfortable of experiences, and the other devices like the InkPad X, InkPad Pro, they do it really well. But what they do is they keep that Scribble app and they put it on their smaller devices too. So you get that ability to make notes effectively any time you want, and you get eraser, you can add text by just selecting a certain range like that, start typing, just type pet, it's easier, press enter, pet goes there, and you can actually go to the thing next to it and change the font size, the type, the font weight, whether you want it bold. I mean, that's a decent amount of functionality when it comes to a device that has nothing to do with note taking. It's pretty impressive, and it's there if you need it. Bookland looks like this. You have bestsellers, categories, English, and you can actually search by different languages, French, Russian, etc. If you click on something, this one for example, which is $45 USD, which we have also noticed the prices on here are very varied. So you'd have ones for $45 and one for like 25 cents. So this is how your buying decision looks. It's under most popular books, Kierkegaard's Writing 3, Part 1. Sorry, I don't know how to pronounce that. You have a little synopsis here, read sample or buy. Reading sample saves it to your home screen where you can just read kind of the first 7 pages. Pocketbook is a very international friendly company. We'll just touch on this for a second. They have a lot of different dictionaries, Danish to English, German to English, English to, I don't know what CS is, it could be Chinese or something like that. They have a lot of different languages. You see, as I'm scrolling here, they have English to Polish, English to Romanian, and vice versa. So they'll always get you covered with the preloaded dictionaries. The overall device isn't that quick, but the gallery is actually pretty snappy. When it comes to typing and stuff, it's like it, you know, plays catch up and stuff, but these high-res HD images are loading fairly well, and although they don't have a dedicated A2 mode, they do have the ability to pinch and zoom and navigate around without ever lifting your finger, and it's all very, very quick. The browser also exhibits a lot of A2 mode-y type features. For example, when you scroll, you can see that everything grays out, and the refresh rate has incredibly gone up, so it's very quick, and the imagery has gone down, and that's very evident of A2 mode. Now, there's no toggle for A2 mode on or off, but they do allow you to do this. And a little geeky note, when you're swiping around on the screen and you want to actually continue swiping, you can lift your finger and continue. Even greater devices than this have not allowed you to do that, but this one actually does with no refresh in between. Because Pocketbook already has devices that occupy the high-end range, the InkPad 3, the InkPad X, etc., they don't really need to put too much onto this device. And what they have left out is the warm lighting. So you do have a glow light, and it works very well, and the distribution is flawless. You can see right to the very bottom corner, top corner. There's no bleeding or overexposure or gray puffing of any kind. However, you only have blue/white lights. So you don't have any of the warm lighting, you don't have the ability to blend them, you don't have the ability to white balance, toggle them on and off, anything like that. You can simply just lower the lighting or raise the lighting. But it actually lowers as you slide. You don't have to let go for it to render. So Pocketbook has a lot of these little tweaks that they've made to make it an overall more comfortable experience for the end user. The Pocketbook Touch Lux 4 Limited Edition is a very nice package, both in the physical package and the device itself. The color scheme, the free case, and the great price point actually makes this a very, very desirable device. And they also give you 2 years warranty on this device, which is actually a very, very nice thing to do, because that gives you peace of mind that if this thing ever breaks, you have some sort of fallback on it. If you guys want to have any other comparisons on this or any other questions, leave a comment down below. And for Goody Reader and a review of the Pocketbook Touch Lux 4 Limited Premium Edition, this is Peter.